Well, it's Thursday. I'm at Manchester Arena. I've got my Backstreet Boys very important person backstage pass, and it's their first gig here in the UK. But not only that, girls, I'm going to meet the boys themselves. Good evening, Manchester! Manchester! Everybody! Hey. Hey! Now you're about to go on stage, but I'm going to grab you before you go and I'm going to ask you a few questions. Right, now you guys all got together to begin with, and it was a natural thing. You weren't put together by a record company. Do you think that that gives your music more credibility?
Well, we feel like destiny brought us together. And I think that the fact that we're a strong vocal group, that all five of us have strong voices, and good songs, good strong songs with great melodies and harmonies. I think that's a key to our success, and working hard.
Because I mean, Europe accepted you straight away. It was amazing, the response that you got. And yet America was much slower. Why do you think that was?
Timing.
Do you think America's tougher on you then?
I mean, they're very critical. I mean, they're very, you know, when it comes to music, I mean, in America, it's like you have to totally be on, and it's like in and out. You can be in and out of there, you know, from one album to the next album. As wise over here, we notice that the fans over here are very loyal, very faithful. You can you have a long career.
Those girls outside today, whoa, no one's shaking them.
We've been in situations before where sometimes you fear for your safety, which is kind of scary, because and you fear for their safety too. We've been in places in South America where we have to travel in a gigantic bus because of the fact that there's so many people outside of the hotel that they would literally push a van over or a car over or something like that. You see people falling down and they're running and they're chasing you and they're getting trampled, and and it's scary to me. I mean, they make us who we are. That's why we're so successful, is because people like what we do.
I must say, I said this last time and I'm gonna say it again. It's because of each and every one of you that came tonight that make us the Backstreet Boys. So enjoy the rest of the show. I love you guys.
Absolutely, so successfully, phenomenally well, all going really amazingly.
Lots of adjectives in one sentence.
Yeah, and lots of hand movement as
right?
well. Who's the real party animal amongst you?
Probably have to say either AJ, Howie, or Kevin.
me, AJ, and Kevin, actually, all, the three always go out to the clubs and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And, like, you know, fancy dancing and stuff like that.
So who's the worst dancer then?
I say Howie. He's not the worst dancer.
No.
I don't, but he does a little bit of his own little thing, mm-hmm. you know, which is
And he's like, chill, baby.
Yeah, sometimes a little too much of the hip gyration thing going on. Hey, calm yourself, baby.
I rate myself as the least best. I can't.
Do you?
I don't like to dance.
Really? Mm-hmm. Do you not like
that? I think that's probably why I don't like to go out to clubs and do all that party stuff. It's because in order for me to get out and dance on the floor in front of everybody and do something, I feel like I make a fool out of myself.
Pretty difficult 12 months of the Rolling Stone thing, the Backstreet Boys year.
You're in hell. It was kind of like a wake up to the business
mm-hmm.
of show business, kind of what we were told about a long time ago.
Yeah.
And having success brings responsibility.
Yeah. We had gone through like a probably 6 to 8 month period where we had no kind of management representation because we were in between getting rid of our previous management and mm-hmm. finding new management. So we were kind of managing ourselves. So mm-hmm.
that was really
we're hard. Not managers.
But not only the business stuff that we went through, but also Brian's surgery.
Yeah.
And then we had some deaths in the family.
Yeah,
and how
I know
he lost
right. yeah.
his sister.
Yeah.
Me and Brian lost our grandfather.
So we just, you know, it was a lot of give and take situations. It was a lot of growing up.
Mm-hmm.
We grew as a group.
Mm-hmm.
We went
it was lucky
personal.
That it wasn't the catalyst for you all to kind of grow apart. It seems as though you've kind of gone like that.
It was headed towards that way,
really?
I would say, and I think we could all agree
really?
With that.
What
just
was...
because of the fact that we were traveling and touring so much
yeah.
that it became so stressful that it wasn't fun.
I go anywhere for
What do you do to make your hotel a bit more homely? What items do you take with you and stuff?
We bring our CD players and our music and we have little DVD players that you can play movies
on. Yeah.
Bring your computer and chat online or bring your PlayStation and your video games.
Yeah.
First thing I do when I get into the hotel, I open up my suitcase and that's my big problem right there. When I open it up, I can't seem to get it closed back again the next day.
Tell me why.